your KRCG 13 Storm Vision Forecast with Zach Paul.
Well, a few areas could find some spot showers, maybe a rumble of thunder tonight, mainly north of I-70 and south of I-44. For most of us, we're going to be dry tonight. Temperatures will fall back into the 70s. Winds will turn to the north, and we'll find more comfortable conditions as we go through the day on your Tuesday. Pretty seasonal temperatures tomorrow morning in the upper 60s to right around 70 degrees. We'd have quite a bit of rain this morning. That has since refired across parts of southeast Missouri and another little boundary across northern Missouri. These showers through the north hold together and slide south. Just a few folks north of I-70 will pick up a little bit of that rain. Otherwise, I think for folks, at least at this point, maybe along I-44, really look like you're probably going to be dry here from the duration of the evening. And with these storms that are out there tonight, once the sun sets, they're going to lose their energy, and you won't have to worry about much as we head into your overnight hours. As far as those rainfall totals, though, higher amounts down around the lake, over 2.5 inches of rain at the lake. Some of you even calling in, telling me you've had close to 4 inches, and a lot of those totals range anywhere from the Bagnell Dam towards the northern shore there along Rocky Mountain over towards Gravois Mills. Again, the Camden County and southern Morgan County, they're being hit pretty hard. Boonville, almost 1.5 inches and over 1.5 inches for Versailles. Temperatures, not bad here. Looking at the low to mid 80s, 85 degrees Boonville right now. Versailles, 86. Looking for the lower 80s from Higbee to Fulton down through Lynn. And pretty quiet skies right now over the lake. It's our quick car cam at the Lodge of Four Seasons. Just a few scattered clouds. Conditions right now in Jefferson City, 84 degrees. Feels like 91 right now in the capital, and our dew point at 73 degrees. Across the region, two little boundaries, and these two boundaries are triggering a few showers. One was a stationary boundary that's to our south. This is what's left of some of those showers from this morning. Now, if they get some of the heat for the afternoon, they're refiring. To the north, this is our actual cold front. This is actually going to bring a little bit more of some relief from that humidity and some of the heat, and it is triggering a couple showers. Very broken along that frontal boundary, and once again, once the sun sets, those storms are also going to lose some energy. So here's what the maps show over the next couple of hours going into the morning on your Tuesday. We'll find quiet skies when you wake up, winds out of the north, and we'll find more of a northerly to a northeasterly wind as we go through the day on your Tuesday. It'll be a very comfortable day, just a few scattered clouds. Tuesday night into Wednesday, maybe a few more clouds. We'll call it a partly cloudy sky, still finding dry conditions. And for the most part, your Wednesday going to be a dry day as well. But by Wednesday evening, we will find the storm system passing to our south, and it could bring a few areas of some stormy skies late on Wednesday. But I think most of us are going to find our rain showers as we go through the day on Thursday. Tonight, your forecast is not bad. Upper 60s to right around 70 degrees, slightly cooler to the north and a little warmer to the south, but still not too bad. It will be another comfortable day for your Tuesday afternoon. Highs in the low to mid 80s. Once again, looking for around 82 to maybe 83 degrees. We'll find similar conditions for your Wednesday, but those rain showers return late Wednesday night. And most of us will find that rain as we go through the day on your Thursday. A warm front will also pass through the area. That will warm our temperatures from the low to mid 80s into the upper 80s. By the end of the week, close to 90 degrees on Friday. That will not only warm our temperatures, but will also bring a return of the humidity. So we will have, looks like, dry skies for the majority of the weekend, but hot, humid conditions return. And by Sunday, we might find a couple more spot showers, but overall, a fairly dry weekend coming up.
So the really comfortable days are tomorrow and Wednesday.
Yeah, it looks really good.
Okay, thank you, Zach.